going to Tesco to pick up some fruit and snacks. Putting some Moroccan oil in my hair. I'm trying my best to keep my color treated hair as healthy as I can. The first time I got it colored was in college. I had no concept of deep conditioning or hair masks or anything like that, like restoring hydration back into hair that's been bleached. And it was so fried, it felt like straw. And my hairdresser was like, not today, Satan. This time I know what I'm doing, at least a little bit more than I did at 22.
I'm gonna see if I can figure this out, but right now I would love a cup of tea. We just housed that Indian food and my stomach is already giving me a preview for the nightmarish ordeal to follow. So what I think I'll do now that I've brushed my teeth is to get rid of all the like spicy flavor. I'm gonna fix some green tea if I can figure out the hot water situation. Good morning. It is a rainy day in Manchester. The bake has left to head over and scout out a coffee shop, and I'm here getting ready and just taking my time. I slept till 8:30, which again, I just really don't ever do. So I got 10 hours of sleep last night and I took like a 45 minute nap yesterday. I think my body is just, all the moving around and change is starting to catch up with me. Last night after I woke up from my nap, or Jake woke me up. Scoot this way, don't I? Stay. I booked a yoga class yesterday at 6:30. It was a yin yoga class for 60 minutes and it was what I needed, just what the doctor ordered. I'm really full. It was probably 30 women in there and a couple of men. And it was at Yoga Soul in Manchester. I got to walk over there pretty easily in 15 minutes. And then Jake and I met up there at the studio and then went over and grabbed Indian food for dinner, which was yummy. There's great Indian food and restaurants that are pretty accessible. So the yin yoga was great. I will say I didn't love that they lit. I kept hearing this like clicking sound. It was loud because it was yin yoga is like really slow and quiet and you hold poses to stretch for like 3 minutes at a time. So it's like really, really deep stretching and just very zen. And I half felt like I dreamt it because I was in such a delirious, like sleepy state. Not a huge problem, but not my favorite thing was this clicking sound. I was looking around, everyone's like in child's pose, and I'm like, where's that sound coming from? And I realized that it was the teacher flicking a lighter and she kept lighting incense and like carrying it around the room. I've done yoga for like 12 years now. I've never seen someone do that in a class. I don't really mind incense, it's not my favorite. After a while, it does start to give me a headache. I'd rather just like light a candle and get that same kind of calming effect. I know candles aren't the best for you either, but whatever. It's one of those things where I'm like, I'd rather just take my chances. I know like if Jake ran that class with me, he would have been like, I would have left because that stuff gives me a headache. So I wish I'd known. I don't know. That just stood out to me. Anyway, the class was great. Dinner was really good. We went to bed early. I just like edited videos for YouTube until I got sleepy, and now it's raining pretty hard, so I'm wondering when I want to just like go ahead and brave it and go outside with an umbrella. I tried a new hair thing. I really like this. It's like I've seen a couple of tutorials on Pinterest and Instagram with like the Kendall Jenner like middle part bun, and I really do like it. You just slick it back in a high bun in a ponytail first, but leave your bangs down if you have like the curtain bangs like I do, and then pin back the bangs so that they create this middle part here, and I would wrap it around and pin them because they're long enough for me to do that now, and then put everything up in a bun. So the way I learned to style a bun, this is how I kind of taught myself, was just like section it in two parts in half, wrap around one piece in one direction with a bunch of bobby pins, and then wrap in the opposite direction with the other piece. So I'll try to make a hair tutorial. I'm really not the best at those, but that shouldn't stop me from trying new reels. So I'd like to do that. When I say reliable for hair, like it stays put, because that requires a lot of bobby pins, so I can like keep it in my head for most of the day, which every woman loves, or every man if you have a man bun. I realized in my packing video, I didn't really show toiletries. Went through a series of just like culling down and bringing as few as I absolutely could. So instead of doing a full toiletry bag, I just took like these two pouches, and this is my makeup bag here. And then I have a tiny little red one for just like smaller things. Really try to bring as like tiny, tiny little apartments and containers of things as I can. So I bring makeup samples with me. Obviously, it wouldn't make sense to bring my full bottle of makeup. I hate wasting, so I will absolutely use this Charlotte Tilbury lip liner to the lowest nub. I hold jewelry in here and tiny little hair pieces. There's a necklace in here. And look at this. A tiny little nail file. So this is me like obsessively trying to be the best packer in the world, TBD on how well that's going. Then I like to bring matches in case I have a candle. And then what I like to do with my makeup brushes, I always have glasses like for drinking water, but there's always an extra one. And so I just like having like my makeup brushes and some of my longer items in there to reach for pretty easily. Do we love this full-length mirror, or do we love this full-length mirror? I know it's still raining kind of hard, but I've got these super comfortable boots, which I brought because one, they're good and walkable. Two, they're cute with the heel. And three, they're pretty good when it's raining outside. They're not gonna get ruined. And so the hotel just came by and dropped off a couple of umbrellas for us, which is great. I love this sweater. I just brought one knowing that it was gonna be a little bit chillier while we were in England. Chunky sweater girly problems, but does it ever just drive you nuts when you wanna wear a sweater and you wanna wear a certain jacket? The sweater's too thick for the jacket. So I'm gonna try that now and see if it works. Friday. I haven't tried these yet. All right, on a scale of, if you had to describe how excited you are, what would you say?
Yes. A 9.7. Probably take that sticker off.
What sticker? So.
I think it's like close to maybe 9:30, 10-ish. Last night was so much fun. We went to a Man U game. I'm still having to, I'm sorry, soccer people. Man U, Man City, it's Manchester United, not Man City. We went to an 8 o'clock game last night, which is really fun. In an environment like that, like at a sporting event where there's such, not just like a national following, but a worldwide global following. They have, this team has 75 million fans all over the world. When you're in the stadium and they score a goal, the crowd's roar is indescribable. They did score one goal at the end and it was just one collective, yeah! I mean, it was so fun. And there was this man behind us who kept shouting things, and in his accent, it just was that much funnier. They have a player whose last name is Onana, and so obviously like people are gonna slap his name into the Rihanna song and sing like Onana, and he kept doing that, and it's just like this old middle-aged man with an English accent, Onana. I mean, so funny. And whenever there was a call that felt unfair or something like not in the team's favor, he'd go, disgrace! I guess one of our players went down on a slide tackle from the other team, and he goes, that's assault! So entertaining. My shoulders were shaking. I just like was trying to control my giggles. Yeah, it was really fun. That was an experience of a lifetime for Jay because he's such a mega fan. So I'm glad we got to do that. It definitely was sweet to see how excited he was. Now I am out for my hot girl walk. I put a little sunscreen sunscreen on. I have tried mixing just a little like travel tube of sunscreen with my Say Glow highlighter. It does add a nice little glow to my face. The goal is to look a little bit more awake. So I'm sure once I step out into natural sunlight, that's gonna show a little more. And then these I'm gonna show, they're also so great for travel. These are the little sample sized containers that you can ask for at Sephora. And so last time I was in there, I asked for the Tatcha moisturizer in a sample because I love it, but I did end up going with a drugstore option. And I posted this on Instagram because I had it at the airport, but it's the Olay Regenerous Micro Sculpting Cream and it's fragrance free. And I had followed a dermatologist who's board certified, who says just in general, whether you have sensitive skin or not, it's just best to go with fragrance free, because as much as we might like nice smelling things, for the most part, that's the better option for your skin. That's not gonna irritate it. My other sample that I got on my last trip to Sephora was the First Aid Beauty Eye Cream. I really like this. It is, I think overall, a pretty clean brand. And this one has, it's not glitter or sparkles, but something in it, it just glows and catches the light really nicely, which is absolutely what I need under my eyes. And so I just put a little bit, goes a long way, and put it under my eyes, and that definitely helps wake me up. And what else will help wake me up is a walk. So I'm gonna go outside.
Or in control of the moment. Right now you shouldn't be struggling. You also shouldn't be blind past the beat of the music.
I'm thinking Vegas. That looks like a fun pink. Thank you.